Good morning, students all. In the last class, we finished about the how current carrying solenoid will behaves as a magnet. What is its magnetic moment? We discussed that one. What will be its magnetic moment? Magnetic moment of the current carrying coil will be M is equal to NIA. This N place we will write number of turns per unit length into I. There we assumed a radius of the coil, that solenoid is A. So NI finally NI pi A square L. This we proved in the last class. How current carrying solenoid will behave as a magnet. What is the magnetic moment of that solenoid? We discussed in the last class. Now we came to the end of this chapter. So next topic will be what is meant by Gauss law. Gauss law in magnetism. Clear? What is Gauss law in magnetism? What is Gauss law in the electricity, electrostatics, how we discussed? The net electric flux coming from a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed in the surface. So pi is equal to q by epsilon naught. This will be electric flux. The net electric flux coming from a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed in the surface. That is Gauss law in electrostatics. Gauss law in magnetism, if we discuss, the net magnetic flux, then net magnetic flux coming from any closed surface. The net magnetic flux coming from any closed surface is always equal to zero. That is Gauss law in magnetism. Okay, so mathematical form as pi m is equal to zero. This magnetic flux we can taken it as the dot product of magnetic induction and area vector. So b bar dot a bar of any closed surface is always equal to zero. That is Gauss law in magnetism. Why the magnetic flux is equal to zero means the role of charge in the electrostatics, same role here it will be played by the magnetic poles. There what will happen in electrostatics? Positive charge, negative charge will be there. In the magnetism, south pole and north pole will be there. Understanding? We cannot get any magnet having a single pole. If a magnet is existing, definitely that magnet will have two poles. One is south pole and one is north pole. That's why net pole strength of that magnet we can consider it as zero. So for example, this is a closed surface. In that closed surface we kept the magnet. Then what will happen? Each pole is having pole strength. These two are equal and opposite. That's why net pole strength value is equal to zero in this case. That's why net magnetic flux value is equal to zero. So the net magnetic flux coming from any closed surface is always equal to zero. Pi m is equal to zero. That is Gauss law in magnetism. Next, after finishing of this, next, what is meant by terrestrial magnetism? What is meant by terrestrial magnetism? How we will define this? So how we will define this is the branch of physics, the branch of physics which deals about Earth's magnetism is called terrestrial magnetism. The point is clear. So the branch of physics which deals about Earth magnetism, Earth is also behaving as a magnet. To discuss about the Earth's magnetic fields, that part of physics will be called as the terrestrial magnetism. Okay, we know Earth will also behaves as a magnet. The magnetic induction of the Earth is around 10⁻⁵ Tesla. The magnetic field or the magnetic induction created by the Earth is 10⁻⁵ Tesla. What is the reason for creating Earth as, why Earth is behaving as a magnet? What is the reason behind that? Up to now, nobody gave the satisfactory explanation for Earth's magnetism. Experimentally, they proved Earth will behave as a magnet. They calculated the Earth's magnetic induction, 10⁻⁵ Tesla, but nobody gave the proper explanation up to now why Earth is behaving as a magnet. But some explanations are there, those are hypotheses actually. So what are that is, one will be, so cause of Earth's magnetism, in that one acceptable theory will be dynamo effect. What is meant by dynamo effect? If we consider the Earth, this is the Earth, let it be. What is the radius of the Earth? 6400 kilometers. This will be radius of the Earth, that's value 6400 kilometers. If we consider the outer core of the Earth, for example, let this outer core is like this, okay, around some 3000 kilometers, some outer core is there for the Earth. So outer core of the Earth will be very hot. That is in theories only, not experimentally proved. No one went to that 3000 kilometer depth and observed. Okay, what is that theory? What it is saying? The outer core of the Earth is in the, is, it will be very hot. This area will be very hot. Clear understanding? There, because of that hotness, what are the metals present in that outer core? They will be in the fluid state, like iron, nickel. What are the metals are there? Those will be in the liquid state, fluid state, those are. When Earth is rotating, these metallic fluids will also rotate. So metallic fluids, everybody, everything is made up of atoms only. Atom is having the charge, it containing protons and electrons. So what will happen? Those circulating charges will create the magnetic field. Because of that, Earth is showing the magnetic effects. Like that, one theory will be there, that will be called as the dynamo effect. So what is the reason for the Earth's magnetism? Means there is no correct explanation up to now for showing the, for explaining the Earth's magnetism. But what the theory dynamo effect is saying, the outer core of the Earth will be very hot. Because of that hotness, what are the metals present in there, like iron, nickel, they will be in the fluid state. When Earth is, since Earth is rotating, these metallic fluids will also rotate. Nothing but charge is rotating in the circular path, that will create the magnetic field. Because of that, Earth is exhibiting the magnetic field. That effect will be called as the dynamo effect. Okay, next, after finishing of that, let us discuss about what are the magnetic elements of the Earth. What are the magnetic elements of the Earth? Okay, so if we consider this is the Earth, okay, about this axis, Earth is rotating, Earth is having revoluting around the sun, Earth is having self-rotation. So Earth is rotating about this axis. This will be called as the geographic axis. Okay, this will be called geographic axis. Here geographic north will be there, here geographic south will be there. This will be called equator. The greater circle drawn perpendicular to the geographic circle, geographic axis will be called as the geographic equator. This is equator. Okay, next, here Earth will also behaves as a magnet. Then how Earth, it will, like we assume it is like a bar magnet, that will be in this format. This angle will be around 11.3 degrees. This is magnetic north. This will be magnetic south. Then this circle will be, that's a greater circle which is perpendicular to the magnetic axis, that will be called as the magnetic equator. This is magnetic equator. This will be called geographic equator. This will be geographic axis. This will be magnetic axis. Clear understanding? So Earth's magnet is not along the geographic axis. It is slightly tilted towards the west. This is north, geographic north, na? This will be east, this is south, this will be west. It is slightly tilted towards the west, making an angle 11.3 degrees with the geographic north. So it is like this. Earth's magnet will be like this. This pole will be called north pole of the Earth. This will be called south pole, magnetic south pole of the Earth. Okay, now what are the magnetic elements of the Earth? How we will define the magnetic elements? See, to understand and to study the effects of Earth's magnetic field, we need three quantities. Those are called as the magnetic elements of the Earth. What are that means? First one will be magnetic inclination, magnetic declination. Second one will be magnetic dip, or it is called magnetic inclination. Third one will be horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. It is indicated by the letter theta. Magnetic dip is indicated by the letter delta. It is indicated by the letter BH. Clear understanding? So to understand about the Earth's magnetism, we need three physical quantities. Those are magnetic declination, magnetic dip, and horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. How we will define them, and diagrammatically how they will represent, let us see. First one will be magnetic declination. This will be defined as the angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian. It is called declination. The angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian, that will be called magnetic declination. What is meant by meridian? The vertical plane passing through the magnetic axis, that will be called as the magnetic meridian. The vertical plane passing through the geographic axis, that will be called as the geographic meridian. How to understand? Try to take one apple or one any circular shape, exactly circular shape. One apple, let us there. One Peru, it is there. Like that you assume. So this is in the form of the sphere, na? What is this? Geographic axis. Axis is just a line. If you cut this along the axis, then you will get this side one piece, this side one piece you will get. This surface is there, na? That will be a plane. That plane will be called as the geographic meridian. Hope you are understanding. So axis means just one line. Plane means what? You this side one half has came. This side will be spherical. This flat surface will be there. That will be called geographic meridian. And this line will be magnetic axis. If you cut along this, if we assume, then that plane will be called as the magnetic meridian. The vertical plane passing through the magnetic axis, that will be called as the magnetic meridian. The angle between these two will be how much? That angle will be called as the magnetic declination. It is indicated by the letter theta. Clear? Try to assume, it will be simple only. Next, what is meant by magnetic dip? How it will be defined? The angle between Earth's magnetic field, the angle between its magnetic field and its horizontal component is called magnetic dip. The angle between its magnetic field and its horizontal component. Its magnetic field is indicated generally by B. Horizontal component is indicated by BH. The angle between B and BH will be called as the magnetic dip or magnetic inclination. Clear? Next, third one will be horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. It is indicated by the letter BH. So how we will define this one is the component of Earth's magnetic field along horizontal. Same in the name itself we can understand Earth's magnetic field component in the horizontal direction along horizontal is called horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Why these quantities are required means to study the Earth's magnetic field and its effects, these quantities will be required. Next, after finishing of this, in diagram, with the help of a diagram, indicate Earth's magnetic elements like that, questions will be there. How to indicate that one? Let us see. Next side heading will be diagram which shows Earth's magnetic elements. Diagram which shows Earth's magnetic elements. Okay, let us assume, consider this as this is magnetic meridian. Magnetic meridian will be a plane which is going along the magnetic axis. That will be called magnetic meridian. Let A, B, C, D, this will be magnetic meridian. Okay, then geographic meridian, if you consider, it will be like this. D, E, F. So in this diagram, A, B, C, D will be magnetic meridian. Next, A, F, E, D. This will be geographic meridian. The angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian will be called as the magnetic declination. So this angle will be equal to theta. So theta is what? Magnetic declination. Clear? Earth's magnetic field will be in this direction. I am assuming it as BE. So BE is equal to Earth's magnetic field. If you resolve this BE into two components, this will be BE. If we resolve this into two components, this will be one component, this will be another component. This is the component along horizontal, this will be the component along vertical. The angle between BE and BH, that will be called as the dip. So this angle will be dip. So delta will be magnetic dip. So in this way, diagrammatically, we can represent the Earth's magnetic elements. Clear understanding? So ABCD will be magnetic meridian, AFED will be geographic meridian, theta will be declination, and Earth's magnetic field will be in this direction, BE. If resolve this into two components, this will be BH, this will be BV. Angle between BE and BH will be magnetic dip. This will be vertical component. Okay? Next, after finishing of this, there diagram is like this. This will be BE, Earth's magnetic field. This will be its horizontal component. This will be its vertical component. Clear? It will be like this. This angle will be how much dip? So if you draw a parallel line here, or if you draw a parallel line here, we can draw any side. This will be BH, parallel line. This will be BV. Or if you draw here, better here delta is there, na? That's why you draw here. This will be BV. Okay? Here one triangle is formed. From this triangle, if you write cos delta value, how much cos delta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, BH by BE. From this, BH is equal to BE cos delta. This is horizontal component. If you write sin theta delta value, what we will get? See, sin delta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, BV by BE. BV is equal to BE sin delta. Clear? If you write tan delta value, opposite side by adjacent side, so this value is equal to BV by BH. Okay? So what we are getting here finally? BV BH is equal to BE cos delta, BV is equal to BE sin delta. Next, tan delta is equal to BV by BH. Okay? then if you square these two, let it be 1, let it be 2. If we do 1 square plus 2 square, what we will get? BH square plus BV square is equal to B square cos square delta, B square sin square delta. B square we can take common, cos square delta plus sin square delta will be 1. So B square is equal to BH square plus BV square. Therefore finally B is equal to square root of BH square plus BV square. This is one more formula. B is equal to root BH square plus BV square. Clear? Like this, all these problems will be there. Simple, simple problems. We have to use these formulas for doing that problems. Next. And last topic will be, these are Earth's magnetic elements. Next, after finishing of this, let us see. And at equator, one more question is important. These are at equator. Delta is equal to 0. Angle of dip value will be equal to 0 at equator. So what is the horizontal component? BE cos 0 degrees. So this will be equal to B. So at equator, we are nearing, Earth is nearer to the equator, na? That's why whenever we are discussing about the magnetic field, we can take BH value. Why to take the BH value? Why we are not considering the vertical component? Means vertical component value almost equal to 0, very negligible. That's why we are not talking about the vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, because we are nearing to the equator. BV is equal to how much? BE sine 0 degrees. So BV value will be equal to 0. Next, after finishing that, if you take poles, delta value will be equal to 90 degrees. Therefore BH value will be equal to BE cos 90 degrees. So this value will be equal to 0. So at poles, BH value is equal to 0. At equator, BH value is equal to B. Try to remember this for 1 marks. These are important. Next, after finishing of this, let us see what is meant by intensity of magnetic field. Wait. Intensity of magnetization . This is indicated by the letter I. Intensity of magnetization indicated by the letter I. How it will be defined? Magnetic moment per unit volume. Magnetic moment per unit volume is called intensity of magnetization. So I is equal to M by V. Magnetic moment we are indicating by the letter capital M, and volume we are indicating with V. So intensity of magnetization means capital N by V. Okay, if you write the SI unit for this, magnetic moment is ampere meter square, volume will be meter cube, 1 meter square will cancel, so ampere per meter, that will be called intensity of magnetization. Next, what is the dimensional formula for this? A L power minus 1. Next, magnetic intensity, it is indicated by the letter H. Okay, so magnetic induction, magnetic intensity, what is the difference you see? For example, here one magnet is there. This is the field created by this magnet. Here I kept one iron plate. Here I kept one iron plate. This iron plate will move towards the, or here I kept like that, you take for your better understanding. Here I kept one iron plate. Okay, then what will happen in this iron? First, magnetic induction will take place. Magnetic induction in the sense, what will happen? Three types of magnetization will be there, na? So that magnetic induction will take place. Because of that, here north south pole will induce, here north pole will induce, then this iron will towards the magnet. Clear? Now what will happen? How much magnetization is taking in this magnetic material depends on the medium between the two. Medium between the magnet and this magnetic material, how much magnetization is happening in this, it will depend. In air, some force which will move. In another medium, with another force, it is moving. What will happen? So it depends on the magnetization happening in a magnetic material. That is depending on the medium between the magnet and the magnetic material. Independent of the medium, how much magnetization is happening in this material, that will be called as the magnetic intensity. Okay, the amount of magnetization develops in a magnetic material which is independent on medium in a magnetic field is called magnetic intensity. Like this we will define the magnetic intensity. Relation between magnetic induction and magnetic intensity in air will be B is equal to mu naught into H. In air this is, in medium B is equal to mu h. In medium B is equal to mu h. In air B is equal to mu naught h. Okay? Independent on the medium, how much magnetization is happening in a magnetic material? In a magnetic field, that will be called magnetic intensity. Last topic will be next. What is meant by susceptibility? What is meant by susceptibility? This susceptibility is indicated by the letter chi. So that letter is representing like this, just like similar to X, it will be there, it will be called chi. Okay, so how it will be defined? The ratio between intensity of magnetization and magnetic intensity is called magnetic susceptibility. The ratio of intensity of magnetization and magnetic intensity is called susceptibility. Chi is equal to I by H. Clear? With this theory part is completed. After this, what are there means? Magnetic materials, types of magnetic materials and their properties. Next, hysteresis curve will be there. Those are deleted from the PU portions, no need for that. So this is the last topic. With this, theory part is completed. From the next class onwards, we will do the problems in this. It will take more or less 1 or 2 lectures it will take place. With that, this chapter will complete. Again, we will start the new lesson, electromagnetic induction, after finishing the problems in this lesson. It may take 1 or 2 lectures. Okay, we will stop now today.